Hello Spidey peeps, I've just got hold of some of this Elegoo 3D printer filament and I wanted yellow because I want to be printing out, well I don't want to be creating the future, but I want to be making some 3D prints of some JCBs and some diggers and some dozers, think gold rush. Now this is the first time that I've bought a refill that's not been a bamboo refill. And I'm really hoping that they work with the bamboo filament spools. It says they do, but Now I know the NFC chips aren't going to work in here, but I just want to make a digger. I'll put that in one of my other sealed half-used bags. I'm not sure whether this is the same. It looks exactly the same as the bamboo. Has it got a slot on it? Yeah. So the bamboo ones have a little slot on it there and it engages with that little slot here. So these could almost be made in the same factory, you know. I wanted to get some yellow bamboo filament, but it was sold out until the 15th of December. And I reckon anything I order at that point is going to get caught up in the Christmas rush. So I just thought this was not too expensive. Probably the same as buying a bulk discount off Bambu. But I thought we'd try this. So it obviously fits with the... spool correctly. And now I've just got to pop this in the printer. I tend to leave this one till it's all in the printer. But I'm going to be risky today. Let's pull... Try not to score the filament. Okay, so pretty much that was exactly the same behaviour. So let's just chop that off straight. I'd normally use my cutters for that, but I'm on the desk and I'm going to put that in the printer and see what it does. Right, this is pretty much a two-handed operation for me, but let's just see whether it picks this up. Here we go, is that twisted and locked already? Okay, I don't know if you heard that. That was a bit traumatic, but finally I've got it in without a tangle. And I mean, it does have a picture of a banshee on it, so let's try that. Okay, sorry about the change in the microphone. I'm doing a screen recorded on this. So, I mean, so many different benches. I decided, let's do a SpongeBob benchy. Yeah, why not? This is set to the A1 Mini. I want it to be P1S. Oh, what is it? What is it doing? Don't say. Don't say. What are you doing? I just want you to be, I just want you to be my printer. P1S, okay. Make sure it's super tack. Yeah, that's got a bigger plate. And then I need to check my device. And it doesn't know what this filament is, but I'm just going to call it Bambu PLA Basic and set it to yellow. And let's just see what that does, see whether it works. Confirm. And then print the plate and set it to my JCB yellow, and have we got the time lapse? Has got to be on and auto bed leveling. Okay, let's see what this filament is like. Okay. Look at the little Patrick. Well, he's not that little, actually. Yeah, not bad. You might have seen on the time lapse, there's a little bit of string in between there. It sort of didn't actually survive me pulling the print off the plate. The rest of it looks quite good. There's a little transition line here. I mean, with all these other bits on it, it's not really a proper benchy. So you can't look for the sort of things that you would normally get on a benchy, but that inside arch looks okay. Yeah, definitely some extra layer lines there, probably to do with his eyes, I don't know. But not bad. that bit's not circular, but that might not be circular on the actual print. So I was very impressed with the lettering on the bottom as well. That came out probably better than any other benchy I've ever printed. So I'm quite pleased with that filament. It seems to be behaving just like a bamboo PLA would, but a little bit cheaper, especially if you just want to buy a one-off. You can get the bamboo filament pretty cheaply if you buy 10 at a time when it's on special offer, but that's quite an outlay. Whereas just to get this delivered for about £11, £12 on Amazon was pretty good. And the fact that you can reuse the spool is a good thing. Yeah, I think I'm going to print something else now, what I actually wanted this yellow filament for. So let's just set that off on the printer.
Okay, let's go for the big moment now and find a dozer to do. Straight out of Compton, well, straight out of Gold Rush. Should be one for P1S. That looks all right, so download and open. Whoa, a lot of things here. Wow, look at the tracks. That's going to be exciting. I hope these all print. That looks complicated. I think I'm going to start by printing this plate out, which is the body. So let's get that sliced and sent to the printer.
Okay, this has been printing, like I said, most of the week. In fact, sorry about the audio on this, because it's still printing now. Only 5 hours left to go, and that's the tracks to do. But I think this has printed out really excellently. I see faces. But I was looking at the model of this, and I thought, you know, this model is so good that it deserves its own video. So please subscribe to the channel. Later on, I'm going to post a video of me assembling this amazing D10. And I'll give credit to the guy who created it then. I mean, it all began, I was just trying to stick these two pieces together. And I was a bit bothered that that was the only bit where I had some stringing on this yellow filament. And there's some more prints to do as well. But the other prints are in a grey filament. And I've got the tracks printing at the moment, which were also in yellow. But that was the only bit of stringing I had, and I was a bit sad about that till I realised that would be on the base. And you know, I got to that point and thought, this is pretty good filament. So it's interesting, I set this to bamboo PLA. You know, call me a cynic, but if you use generic PLA and set the colour, I wonder whether bamboo would say, well, we don't optimize it for a specific filament. We generalize it. So many, many generic filaments will work with it. However, if you buy our PLA, it's going to print perfectly. So I bought this and set it to bamboo PLA. And it works great. Thank you, Elegoo. And thank you for also doing a refill so we save some of the plastic. But okay, so I think this yellow filament is fantastic. I'm going to assemble this now. As I said, that'll be in a different video. This definitely was value for money, this yellow Elegoo filament. Glad I bought it. Okay, spider peeps, so drop me a comment below. Let me know if you've tried this Elegoo on a bamboo or on any of the other printers that come with reusable spools. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you for the next one. Bye. Okay, so thanks for watching Spider Peeps. I hope you enjoyed this. In fact, my white bamboo filament has just run out. So I actually went and ordered myself some white PLA as well. So I'll get on with putting this on the spool now and using this, and I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time. Oh my goodness. That'll go in there, won't it? Is that illegal?